Well, here I am at the Evergreen Restaurant, and I'm here to meet a friend of mine, an old friend, by the name of Mike Russell. He's got a great publication, and I want to chat to him all about it. How about that?
Yeah.
I'll take a picture of you. Hi, Mike. How are you?
Hey, I'm okay.
I already introduced you.
Yeah.
Long-time friend, and gosh, I tell you, that's... You've been in Big Bear a long time. How long have you been here?
I think I started coming up here in 1987. I've been living here since 1993.
Wow.
Yeah, it's kind of fun. It's
and you've been
place.
In the publishing business for a long, long time.
Right, yeah.
Publication on all sides of it. From
all sides
publishing
of it.
To sales and everything.
Yeah. It's been fun.
I know. You started a new publication that, when did you start it? I don't want to tell what it is yet.
Okay, I started that in November of 2001.
Really?
Yeah.
It was just a small one at that time.
It was a little one. I didn't bring one along, but anyway, it was a Reader's Digest size.
I know it.
And it was called Air Resorts Magazine.
Sure.
And we circulated it around the... around the various fixed base operators, which are like service stations for airplanes at general aviation airports in the western United States, two or three states we started out with.
That was pretty good. You got a niche.
Mm-hmm.
You found the niche of airports, because a lot of people fly in, they fly out, and what do? They pick up publications.
We had that happen today.
Did you really?
Yeah, there was a fellow, actually yesterday, there's a fellow on a charter jet going from California to Sedona, Arizona, and he picked up the magazine on the jet, and he liked it so much that he called my sales guy in Las Vegas and talked to Jim and said, hey, how do I get a subscription? So he referred him to me, and I talked to the fellow, or he sent me an email, and so I need to get in touch with him. But he said this was the best travel magazine he'd ever seen.
So I know it. It's so
we
well
were amazed.
Hold it up. Let me see the cover. Sure. It is called Jet Setting Magazine. Ooh, and look at that pretty girl on the front.
Yeah, she,
that's a model, isn't it?
That's right. She works down and lives down in Palm Springs, and she works down in Palm Springs at a hotel down there.
Oh, really?
Yes, at the front desk.
And what plane is she in front of?
That's a B-17G at Palm Springs Air Museum.
Oh, sure.
That's a World War II bomber, one of our major bombers.
While it's jet-setting, it really is... not filled with aviation stories, it's filled with points of interest and travel and everything.
It's more like for the passengers on charter aircraft, and also the niche being the pilot that flies
sure.
them, or the pilot that has his own plane and flies his family or wants to know various places to go. So we do reviews of restaurants and like Evergreen, where we are right now. And also we do reviews of hotels and spas and golf courses all over the country. Now we instead of being in about two or three states, we cover 11 western states. Texas, we're into Oklahoma and Florida, Georgia, and all over the place.
Really? It has grown.
Yeah, it has grown.
And this is a 70-pager, the winter issue.
Yes.
How often do you publish?
Every other month.
Every other month.
Mm-hmm. Boy, wow. What a lot of time we put in, too. A lot of work.
So 6 issues a year.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't it be great to get one of the major airlines, put it in their front pockets? And someday it's going to happen.
I think so, because right now we're in several different charter jet airline fleets.
Uh-huh.
So we get into some pretty nice airplanes.
Oh, you bet. And you're in some of the Las Vegas private jets.
Yes, we are. We are. They fly up there and back. We have one family up there that just likes to fly down to Murrieta, French Valley Airport, and go visit friends. They do that with a multi-million-dollar jet. Really neat. There are two dogs, of course, too.
Well, certainly you have to have the dogs go along. So anyway, and you have a staff? How many on your staff? You don't need a big staff to put this out, really, because you contract. You use a lot of what we call stringers, or
that's right,
the people who write stories for you.
It's exactly correct. We have people that write for us all over the country, and New Mexico and Texas and just all, California, of course, and all over the place. And we have people who are interested in talking with us about being on the cover of the magazine. We always have a beautiful model. In our spring issue coming out, we have the one of the top 10 models in the Hawaiian Tropic Tanning Products Beauty Contest of 2006, and that's Sandra Nilsson. And Sandra is Miss Stockholm, Sweden, and she'll be on our cover. Just a beautiful girl. She's back in New York now, going to agencies looking for model work, and she's also going to be writing an article about the Super Bowl for us.
Oh, good.
And I sure am. That's a challenge for her because she's writing in English, and she speaks, of course, good English, and
sure.
She speaks Swedish too. I wouldn't want to try to write a story in Swedish myself.
That's for sure.
Yeah.
You know, one in this issue that I really enjoyed was the General Patton Museum.
Oh.
That was so interesting, and it's sort of so close to us. It's down in the desert area.
Right.
And I mean, he was the great tank general.
Really was.
Armored vehicle general.
True.
And he was the one that really started Fort Knox.
He did?
Yes.
Oh,
I mean,
yeah,
it's
that's
the,
right.
Fort Knox, are the our gold depository, is right in the middle of the military reservation.
Mm-hmm.
And it's guarded by all of our armament.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really right. Interesting.
This particular one, this museum is 30 miles east of Indio on I-10
right.
at Chiraco Summit. And it's just been growing and growing over the years, so we decided to do a feature on it.
Yeah.
And show some pictures of the old camps, the training grounds for all the soldiers.
Sure.
We used a Silver State helicopter's R-44 helicopter to take a tour of that museum, and also to take a tour of Munson Canyon up into Joshua Tree. And we do an executive charter tour in each issue, and we use that helicopter, which is just incredibly efficient because fixed-wing aircraft, they go pretty fast, and you can't do the maneuverability thing that you need to go back. Oops, I missed that shot.
Oh,
can
sure.
you go back, and we'll do it again?
So the helicopter is the right,
terrific.
Right way.
Yeah, it's terrific.
Do you fly in them?
I don't fly them. I just fly in them.
I mean, fly in them.
I do.
Oh,
we
wow.
take the door off, and I take my camera, and cool. we take off, and we go all over. First thing you know, you're 6 feet off the ground, then you're 500 to 1,000 feet off the
wow.
ground.
Wow, I've
over.
Never been in a helicopter.
110 miles an hour.
I need to go one of these. I love flying.
Oh, it's so fun.
So.
Why don't we just plan to take you on a trip?
Sure, and
would
we can
like
film
that?
It. Yeah, we
okay.
can film it and,
yeah.
and
if you'd
do
like
it.
That.
Yeah, oh, I'd love it.
It's certainly
Boy,
fun.
You bet you.
Yeah, it's fun. We found a big rock out of off of the Dana Point area, and it's just covered with seals. And so we want to go back out there and film those seals. There's one male out there, and boy, he's in charge.
Oh, wow. He's really got a harem.
Yeah. So, you know, this is the fun thing you can do if you're a millionaire. This is the fun thing you do if you're a publisher of a magazine about millionaires, which is a lot cheaper.
That's right. This is a quality publication.
Thank you.
I notice it's just full color, wonderful stock, paper stock. I mean, it is right amongst one of the best in the country. I mean, I congratulate you on it.
Oh,
I mean,
you.
I'm impressed.
Thank you.
Very much so.
Thanks, Ron.
It's really something. And the stories, it's, what I like about it is there are no long stories covering two or three pages.
That's
pretty
right.
much they're short stories on one page or two pages.
Right. We do what we call a quick read.
Uh-huh.
Little copy, but enough to tell you exactly what's going on, but beautiful eye candy pictures.
Sure. Now, you going out, and I know you're a great photographer also.
What? I don't know.
Yeah, well, you are. I mean, you
look
know.
Out.
Yeah, I know. So what, have you had any experiences, any close calls or
Yeah, anything? I almost dropped my camera out of the helicopter one
Oh,
day.
Really?
I didn't have a strap on it. It has a strap on it now.
Oh, sure.
But that was, actually, if you're going 110 miles an hour and the door's off, you just barely put your finger out the door and it bends your finger back. That's a lot of
oh,
headwind.
Really? Oh, I'll bet it.
But you're going to see somebody down there and they wave at you and you wave back and that's a mistake.
Sure.
But anyway, I managed to hold on to the camera, thank goodness.
Oh, that's something. So how do you choose the models? Do they come to you, or do you sort of look around? I know this one here, and you got a beautiful centerfold.
Oh, that was really wonderful with Palm Springs Air Museum allowing us to go in there and
right.
do fashions by Ferrari furs down in Palm Desert, really beautiful furs. And what we do is we have one of our people on the team, Susan Lane Leonard, down in Solana Beach, California. She pretty much has the ability to pick out great models and beautiful models, very classy. She's been in the model agency business for, gosh, I guess 25 years. She's retired now, but still is very active in public service and fundraising and charitable ventures and just seems to come up with the most beautiful ladies that you ever saw, and they're just as nice as they can be.
I know, and it's the covers really tell you. I mean, you can't resist the magazine. You got to pick it up and read it.
We do that's have pretty, trouble keeping them in.
I know, that's pretty smart, really.
Yeah.
Now you distribute these at a lot of airports,
yes.
hotels,
yes.
restaurants,
yes.
and here at the Evergreen, I see you got a big rack of
yes,
them.
Yes, we do. Yeah, we had a call from Pocatello, Idaho today from a Best Western hotel up there, and they said, can we get these every issue? And I said, sure, you can. Every issue, we can send them to you. He said, well, we sure would like to. How many do you want? I asked, and the guy says, well, how many can you send? And I said, well, what do you need? I'm the publisher. And so he says, well, I'd like 50. And I thought, gulp, okay, so we'll send
sure.
you 50. And he
sure.
says, yeah, we'll put them in the rooms. And I said, oh, great.
Yes.
So then we have other hangar hotel in Texas that has a great big air aviation hangars, and they put people in them instead of planes. But they look like their hangars, you know, they used to be.
Uh-huh.
And they put them in their rooms, and they show them off to people down there. And it's just that kind of thing. You know, they're at airports, but they're also at hotels.
Wow.
So it's fun.
Now, that one in Texas, it used to be a hangar and is converted to a...
That's correct.
To a hotel?
Yeah, they have a wonderful bar, a saloon, a restaurant, and they have seminar areas and things like that, and it's called the Hangar Hotel.
Really?
It's probably www.hangarhotel.com. But it's interesting because hangar can be misspelled. It's H-A-N-G-A-R. And I looked it up one day, and I thought, I've been spelling it wrong.
So
it worked out well.
And it's at an airport.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, right.
Yes,
probably
western middle of Texas and all
wow.
that. Yeah, it's really neat. And they have so much general aviation nowadays with the charter jets, and they're soon to have little jets. Very little jets are going to be VLJs. They're going to be and are now being manufactured actually by several companies, and they'll be landing at airports like at Big Bear here, and carrying 6 or 7 passengers down to, say, like Ontario Airport or LAX or wherever.
Sure.
They'll be little jets.
This is a great reading publication. I mean, you sit there and you can read it several times because you miss some of the things.
It's
I mean,
fun.
In this issue, you've got global jet setting, visiting Thailand, Paris, Canada, and Mexico.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
It's a travel magazine.